I want you guys to switch off your phones and concentrate, because we gotta show you this little shot. So enjoy it. Watch this. You want to smoke?
No. The thing is, the silver Melissa Brown, he was born on the 6th of May 1989. He's one of two siblings in his family. And he fell in love with the music. His family, they played their music in the home radio. Brown was influenced with the 80s music and written by Michael Jackson. He knew that he was obviously not going to college, not going to be able to go to college to do his courses. But at the same time, you can do college courses and stuff like that online and other things. At the age of 17, he done things that none of musicians done that before. He went to school in Virginia, but he could no longer do full schedule and his classes, so he just teaching pieces from 2 to 3 hours in the morning. But anyway, you want to know about this music?
Yeah, sure, why not?
They want to know about Chris Brown music for you.
Oh, how much they gonna pay me?
Don't know. You ask them. How much you gonna pay him?
Up to him.
Okay, a lot, baby. I say it. Okay, like any young boy, he was into a lot of music, and he wanted to be very now rapper. Okay, at the age of 11, people start to notice about his vocal talent, and they start to look for a record opportunity. And the age of 13. He moved to New York City, which I wish to go there, man. Again, he stayed there for 2 years. And in order to begin singing here, at the 16th release, to his very first self-titled album, Curse of Born, in 2005. The first track of his album, which named Run It, marked as number one on the U.S.
I just found something online. They say, according to MTV News, Brown stated, "I am still going to keep it up so my younger fans can continue to listen to my music." But I got a couple of joints on their lap for some of all the people.
Oh, the new album was released by T-Pain, you know. It was a need as the second single album. Kisses became more successful and popular. And by the way, the success of Wall to Wall reaching number one on the US. The next hit was Yo, Excuse Me Miss. He came on second top 10 hit in the US, listed at number 7 and 13. And the UK was sold over 155,000 copies within 7 days. Within a year, it became a double breaking up.
In early 2009, Chris was linked romantically to singer Rihanna, but the pair apparently denied the rumors but eventually admitted the relationship after photos leaked of the two together on the internet and definitely doing it till snuggling up. Chris Brown was arrested on the 8th of February 2009 for the suspension of making criminal threats, and his father alleged that he committed domestic violence against his girlfriend Rihanna. And that turned him into Los Angeles Police Department, Wilshire Station, because of an argument with fellow singer and girlfriend Rihanna in Los Angeles, Hancock Park. The police reported did not name the female in the incident as a policy, but stated that the female had suffered visible injuries. His performance at the Grammy Awards was cancelled, as well as his appearance at the NBA All-Star Games, radio stations have pulled his music off. Christopher Brown was released on £50,000 the night of the Grammy Awards. However, the pop star Rihanna was reported and he will have to present at the court on the 5th of March 2009 for this matter. Hence that, Christopher Brown released a statement saying, "Words cannot begin to express how sorry and saddened I am over what transpired. With God's help, to immigrate at the time."
Bounce. I like you. Bounce. Come here, girl. Come here, girl.
In
come
this
here,
quiet girl. Night, I want to tell you guys about Christopher Brown's comment and context of his songs. As a teenager, most of the context of his work is based on life, love, and sex. He also based his songs on his personal experience and fantasy. In one of his songs, he described his love and passion for dance forever. Christopher Brown always explained how he will cherish and respect his girl and will always be everything she will need it. In honest, he expressed how an action he was to be an adult and how all the fun he always wished. On his superhuman is a bad feeling, a heart beating that does not belong to him. He was weak and he could barely stand on his feet, but superhuman changed his life. Superhuman made him see his real self. It also made him strong, and all his problems were solved. Thank you. It's the obligation song. He wanted for his mother for being supportive and understanding throughout his life. And it's also for his fans, because without them he will be nobody. Just fine. It's his song which related to his personal relationship. He was trying hard to keep something that he was never there. Relationships are built on trust. And since they can't trust each other, it's better they stop trying. He wants he to get someone better than him. And he prays that she will be happy. Christopher has a good work of art where all of his songs are music videos. It's very attractive. And now, I'm going to call one of our friends, Paquito, to ask her about Christopher Brown artwork. So, wait for me. Paquito, can you just tell us about Christopher Brown artwork? Okay.
Chris Brown's motivation. Chris Brown wants to inspire people with his music. He wants people to know about his talent and passion. He wants to be loved for what he does. He wants to contribute to the music industry. And he wants to make a place for himself in the world. And his aim was to be recognized.
I need you, boo. I gotta see you, boo. And the hearts all over the world tonight. Said the hearts all over the world tonight. I need you, boo. Gotta see you, boo. And the hearts all over the world tonight. Said the hearts all over the world tonight. Hey,
Black and
Beats
vibes, baby.
Ooh, you're a stunner. Hot little figure. Yes, you a winner. And I'm so glad to be